guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel. I feel like I wasn't on here for quite some time. The reason being is I think that I'm just so jet lagged, so I'm like awake at random times, I'm asleep at the other random times. I'm just kind of like on and off the game, and then I have to go to work and all that jazz. So hopefully my schedule is pretty on point now, so I'll be pretty consistent with my uploads. I missed you guys a lot. I know it's kind of like cliche, like please my ass, you did not miss me, but I did. Like I miss making videos, I miss interacting with you guys and just like talking, you know? So hopefully you guys missed me too. Anyways, for today's video, I'm going to be doing a review and a lip swatch video on this new Sephora Favorites Give Me Some Nude Lip Set. So this does retail for $28 US and I believe $34 Canadian. So I will leave the link down below if you guys want to pick this up for yourself. And it is, I believe, like a limited edition for the time being. Like usually when these sell out, they sell out for good. Now, Sephora has been releasing a whole bunch of different Sephora Favorite sets, which I feel like could be really nice, and it is really nice. Like, I never seem to miss out on them. But on the other hand, I can understand the feeling of being overwhelmed because it's like so much, you want it all, but then you're like, do I really need it? So that's why I'm here today to share with you guys lip swatches for this little set to see if you guys want to spend the money on it or if it's something that you're gonna skip on. So in this little lip set, we are getting one full-size lip product and then five deluxe sizes ranging from different nude shades and different nude finishes. So this is how the packaging looks up close. You guys can see hopefully the like glittery effect the lid has, and then of course every single lip product that's included in there. So then once you open up the package, whoa, this is how it looks on the inside, just like their other Sephora Favorites Give Me Some Lip Sets look. I'll share with you guys swatches and then lip swatches as well, and then I'll indicate what product is full size and then which products are deluxe sizes. So let's get started. The first lip product we have here is from Buxom, and this is one of their full-on lip polishes in the shade Sugar. And this is a deluxe size. So this is how the Buxom full-on lip polish looks on the lips. It's basically a lip gloss. And then that's how it looks once it's swatched. It's a beautiful nude shade. It has a nice shine to it. And it has little particles of like micro glitter in there, but it's not like gritty on the lips and you don't feel anything either. And you can barely see it too. So I feel like it's just in the package. I really enjoy these Buxom full-on lip polishes. I own, I think, two or three full sizes, a few of these deluxe sizes, and they're such a great quality. It definitely gives like a plumpier effect to the lips. So you kind of feel like a tingling sensation for like the first few minutes, but it's not crazily uncomfortable like the Too Faced ones. I feel like those are like deathly and these are so not. I really do like the shade of this lip gloss as well because I feel like it's just like a perfect nudish brown shade. It's like your lips but better kind of color, and it's great to wear on its own plus on top of a lipstick. So that's the first lip product. I'm totally in love with it. Alright, then we have this little deluxe size lip product. This is by NARS and this is one of their lipsticks in the shade Orgasm. So this is how Orgasm looks on the lips. Like, that sounds so weird to say, like, Orgasm, what type of name is that? And then this is how it looks once it's swatched. It's a beautiful, nice peachy type of color, and it has like a gold reflex to it. Now this is the kind of lip product that you would have to reapply throughout the day because it definitely fades away pretty fast. It does fade away really nicely and it is a very comfortable lip product to wear, so it's definitely one of those lip products that you would throw in your purse and then like call it a day, you know what I'm saying? So I do like that, and I think the shade is really nice and very wearable. It's also the kind of lip product that you don't need a mirror to put on. You can just like throw it on like that, mix your lips together, and it looks good. So that's NARS, that's Orgasm by NARS. All right, now moving on to the next deluxe size lip product. This is the Tarte Tardis Lip Paint in the shade Exposed. I don't know why I don't own this shade in the full size. This lip product is stunning. If you guys know me, you guys know that this is my kind of shade. This is a gorgeous nude shade, which I feel like would suit so many different skin tones. It has a little bit of a pinky undertone to it, but not so pinky. You know, it's more nude, I would say. And then that's how it looks once it's swatched. It definitely dries down very fast, and these are freakishly comfortable. Like, you apply it, it feels a little bit wet in consistency. After like, I don't know, 10 seconds, it dries down and it is bulletproof. So you can eat, you can drink, you can do whatever you want, and it's not gonna transfer on anyone or anything. I think it's stunning, and I'm so about this lip product. Honestly, this whole thing was worth it just for this for me. So I'm obsessed with this, love it. Next up, we have this adorable deluxe size hourglass lip product. This is the Girl Lip Stylo in the shade Futurist. And this is retractable, which is awesome. So this is how the Hourglass lip product looks on, and like I mentioned, it is retractable, so it makes things so much easier. The lid just clips on like that, and then this is how it looks once it's swatched. It's definitely a bit similar in tone with the Tarte lip product, but the Hourglass one has a little bit more of a brownie undertone to it, and then the Tarte one has a bit more of a pinkiness to it. But the formula of this is definitely very different than the Tarte one. This has a nice glossy feel to it, very very comfortable. It feels extremely moisturizing, but it gives a nice amount of color as well. I was so excited that this was included in here because I remember when these released, I wanted to pick up a few, but then I saw the price and I'm like, no. But the thing is, with these little deluxe sizes, I think it's perfect because look, you get a nice amount of product in there, and I know I'm never gonna go through this, so this is like genius. So I'm really excited about this one, and then the color is honestly spot on. I'm obsessed. All right, moving on to the next lip product. This is actually the full size lip product that's included in this set, and this is the Urban Decay Vice Special Effects lip product in the shade Fever. This is how Fever looks on the lips, and definitely not something that I'm used to, but something that is very fun to play around with. I would probably wear it on top of a lipstick just because on its own, I mean, it looks pretty cool, but like I feel like on top of a lipstick, it'll be like boom, you know, like on top of a nude lipstick. Whoa. That's how it looks once it's swatched. It has a whole bunch of like micro glitters in there in many different colors, mainly like this blue type of shade, and it has like a peach undertone to it too. So the question you're probably asking is, does it feel like gritty on the lips? It totally does not. It has a little bit of like a tightening feel once it's on, but it's not like crazily uncomfortable, you know what I'm saying? Like you feel like it's there initially, but then you go on your day and you don't feel like there's anything there, you know? So I really do like this. I think it's a very unique lip product. Like I mentioned, I don't know if I would wear it on its own, but on top of a nude lip product, whoa. And the packaging of this is so nice. It feels so sturdy and like legit and cool, and just like I like it. All right, and then moving on to the final lip product. This is a deluxe size lip product by Smashbox, and this is one of their Be Legendary liquid pigments in the shade Mauve Wife. Yeah, Mauve Wife. So this is how Mauve Wife looks on the lips, and this is nude, I will say, but it definitely leans more towards like the rosier family, you know? And then that's how it looks once it's swatched. There's no glitter in there, just a nice cream formula. This is not kiss proof, so it doesn't dry down. It does transfer, so just have that in mind. For me, I wasn't crazy about this lip product, mainly because I think the shade is not my preferred lip product shade, but I do know that this type of color would work on a ton of different skin tones, so there's a plus. And here, just a little close-up of all the swatches of the lip products included in this set. You get a nice selection of different finishes and a really nice selection of like nude shades. So if you're someone who loves nude lip products, this might be a perfect set for you. So that's pretty much it. That was everything that was included in the Sephora Favorites Give Me Some Nude Lip set. Whoa. You guys know that I'm all about that nude life, so this was definitely a set that was right up my alley. I know I get a ton of use out of every single lip product that's included in here. I hope you guys enjoyed this and found this helpful. I do specifically think that this Sephora Favorites set definitely hit it out of the park for me at least, so hopefully it did for you too. If you guys pick it up, I hope you enjoy it. Let me know if you guys will pick it up, or let me know if you guys are gonna be like, no. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed once again, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.